How to create a Bootstrap thumbnail gallery. So this is the part that we are going to learn in this tutorial, so stay tuned. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. Today we will be learning about how to create Bootstrap thumbnail gallery. But before that, we need to know why we are creating all these things. If we just look into this, an admin, he particularly uploads an image both under small thumbnail version and a big version. And that image or thumbnail should be stored into database. From database, it will be fetched as a row. And that fetched version of thumbnails, that means those small images, those will be displayed in the front part, in the front end design, that means in your index page, as we can see over here. And on clicking each of these thumbnail images, corresponding big images will reveal itself either in a new tab or in the same tab. We need to fetch those larger images too whenever required. That means whenever these small thumbnail images are clicked upon. Now the question is, we are practically not working on this dynamic part. That means dynamic images, because this is a part of programming and programming will be discussed later on after we have completed this front-end development version. In this part, we will be practically concentrating upon how this front-end display should look like. So this is the part practically that we are concerning up to this point, making all those thumbnails into its proper position. That means this part. This is the front-end development in case of Bootstrap mobile responsiveness. Now, first of all, if we get back into our project and we can see that this is another container class that has been created in this purpose. And here we have used a row, and inside this row we have consumed 3 grids each. That means all these thumbnails, those will be consuming up to 3 grids for each. Now let's bring on some images over here. First of all, we are bringing on and here we can see that a class has been created which is known as image responsive. Now instead of using this image responsive, if we use another class here which is known as image circle, first of all let's get acquainted with this. You can see that an image circle has been produced over here, and then we are creating another class which will be known as image rounded. And here it is. We can see that it is another view over here. Now if we just press Ctrl Shift M and we get down, and we can see here that all those images are right into track over here. Press Ctrl Shift M again and get back into your original preview. These are all the classes. Those are practically used in describing those images, and that is what we can see as a result of different classes used along with. And another part, the last thing that we can see over here is image thumbnail. Now this is practically the class that we are about to use all over. You can see that an image thumbnail has been produced with a white border. So we can see that for the first case it is image responsive. For the second case we have used the class image circle. In the third case we have used the class image rounded. And in the fourth case, this is the thing that we need to practically concentrate on, image thumbnail, that we are about to use as we have used here. As we can see here, these are practically those, all those images, those are using the class image thumbnail. Now for the time being, let's get back to our project. And here, instead of using some inline CSS here, we have to delete all those things. So that is why we will be creating a different class which will be known as image thumbnail. Here it is. Now if we just press Ctrl S and reload, we can see that these things are now appearing over here. I think we have made some problem, that is why it is showing something different. Here it is. Okay, now we have created a particular div, and I think it needs some kind of margin bottom. That is why we have provided a padding top of 1 em practically. So all we need to do, we need to provide the same padding into the bottom part, and that is what we are creating here. Nice. So we can see that all these four images, those are now practically in the part, in the position. The first thing is we need to place them into the central position, and this is the caption that in the second case that we need to introduce into our part. So that is why we will be using here this is the first one. So let's have a check on it. It should be over here, and we can see that the class caption is been introduced over here. So all we did, we just introduced another div class, and it will be placed in just beneath this div image thumbnail, and it will be using a class known as caption and with a paragraph beautiful red. Now in the same manner, just copy this thing, we are placing right beneath it . Now here it is, all those things are right onto track, and we can see that all those things are placed right over here. Those are with caption along with these captions, and all of them are having a white border. That means those are inside this image, this div class image thumbnail. Now all we need to do, we need to copy this entire row. All those things are right now inside our banner 11 class name. Now the problem is all those things are practically taking aside. You can see that all those things are in the left alignment. So we need to place them in the central position such that they look quite good. And that is what we need to do over here. So, or we are using a banner 11. So if we now just add this term text align center, then everything inside those should be aligned into the central position. And as we can see that all these images along with their captions, those are practically aligned to the central position. We do not have a need of this banner 11 caption. Everything is defined over here in this banner 11. As we have defined here text align center, that means any content which is present over here, it will be aligned in the central position. And this is the exact thing that is being executed over here. So this is the thing that we need to know. What did we learn from this tutorial? The first thing that we learned is different image classes that is used along with. This is the first part. This is the second part, how to introduce those thumbnail classes, such as those things will be in a thumbnail version as we can see over here along with a caption. The third thing is you know now how to use this caption right over with it, and the fourth thing is you now know how to make them equally spaced and in a centrally aligned condition and what to do in. And another thing that we need to know from this tutorial is how to customize all these things. If you do not wish to have this red border, if you wish to have something else, some else color will be placed over here, then all you need to do, you know the drill, just press F12, select the arrow over here and div class image thumbnail, and you can see that here goes the background color, from where you can choose any color you want. If you want to keep this one, or if you want to keep this one, any color that you wish to provide over here should be chosen from here. And once your color has been chosen from here, all you need to do, you need to copy this image thumbnail class from here and paste it into your custom.css, and then you need to change that background color, and it should be replaced with that particular color code that you have derived from here. These are all the things that we have learned from this tutorial. Hope you guys have liked this tutorial. If you guys have liked this tutorial, then do not hesitate to hit the red subscribe button. Hope to see you guys in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.